we need to know and need to understand how important is the efforts of the GIST community and, of course, the GCRF in this, because without our support, the doctors have a hard time getting grants, and they shouldn't have to be put in that position. They should be concentrating and focusing on what needs to be done so that we could be kept alive. And they have done that for quite many years. You know, as I'm repeating myself now from times before, GCRF is one organization that doesn't get compensated for anything that is being done. In other words, we are not on salaries, we don't pay rent, so all the donations, basically dollar for dollar, that comes in goes back to the researchers in their labs, and it's being designated for research for GIST. It is very important to understand that part, because in other cases, a big chunk of the money actually goes for administrative costs, and that's not what we want, since we are dealing with a very unpredictable cancer that is much more complicated than the known cancers. And they, of course, they don't have the problem with grants or a lot of the funding. We do. And so today, we are very grateful to be here, because we are constantly supporting the efforts of Memorial Sloan Kettering, starting with Christina Antonescu, who has been the GIST researcher in her lab, and she's also worked not only on the adult side of the GIST, but also pediatric GIST. We have Dr. Rhonda Mateo, who is working on the immune in the GIST, in the immune system, which is very important. For most part, many people might not go there, but just think, I myself have been a patient on Glivec since 2001, and just we have to realize what that chemicals and what this chemo, so to speak, is doing to our body and how the immune system works in that particular case. And not only with Glivec, but even with the other agents, that the other drugs that we, many other GIST patients are taking. Of course, there's other people that have resistance to Glivec, or they have pediatric or wild mutations or other mutations. And that's all we've learned, of course, from coming to these presentations, because we got educated from our doctors that did the presentation. But we are very grateful also for two main supporters in our work, is two pharmaceutical companies that have been actually behind us 100%, and one of them is Novartis, the other is the Pfizer company. We both have, right here we have Leslie from Pfizer, from Novartis. Leslie, take a, say hello, and Manny is from Pfizer, and Manny, say hello. He's representing the Pfizer company, of course, and we have another representative also, right? Yes. We are very grateful for that. And this situation, by being supported by these pharmaceutical companies and other sponsors, it makes it easier for us to basically focus on the donation that come in, and we need to give the 100% in for the research. Of course, we have present, we have two people from our GCRF, Pamela Fedowich, who is on our board, and Dr. Mark Lensman, who actually was kind enough to work hand-in-hand with Dr. Karen Brown. And we are very happy that Dr. Karen Brown is here today. But overall, we want to thank all of you, because we couldn't do it alone. And the support, the continuous support that you people are giving us, and my heart is very warm when I look around and I see all my friends and my family of the GIST patients and their families and their spouses. So it makes me feel very good to see that they've always been there for us and continuously and graciously gave and have been to all the events. As you all know, we have different events, and I think with that I will finish. And before I say that, also, I have to thank one person that is very special, Dr. Ephraim Kasper, who is not have been my oncologist from day one, but who is also been a consultant to GCRF. And he's a very special man. Thank you, sir. And the other thing I wanted to say is this. We are now trying to bring the awareness and fundraise in many ways. For most people that are not really informed about the things that we do, as we have Works for a Cure, and of course, the first one and the main walk is in New York. We have a walk in California, in San Jose, California. We have one walk in Washington. We have a walk in Oregon. We have different events that are dinner and auctions. And we also have a bicycle ride, 1,000 mile for a cure that started in 2006 in memory of Peter Thomas, who passed away. That was his vision. The first bicycle ride, it was from Scotland, from England to Scotland. The second one was in 2009, and from Montreal to New York to our walk. And this year, 2012, it will be in South Africa. There's over 30 bicycle riders that will participate from different countries, from all over the world, and this is how we bring awareness. So, and we raised our funds. So we're not only in this country, but we are in other countries that we do whatever we can to bring awareness. Not all of us are fortunate enough, like myself, for instance, to be a cancer patient that is with facilities that known about GIST. You have to remember there's a lot of patients out there that are being treated by doctors that don't have the education or the knowledge about GIST. And that is where a lot of the doctors have been very gracious to help me, help others. Ron is one of them. He's here. And anytime I called on Bill Tapp, he's been great. And Christina, of course, too. But, I mean, you have to remember how devastated it is to be told that you have just be a rare form of cancer and you really don't have a doctor that you could call on or a doctor that really knows anything about GIST, and it's horrifying, it's devastating. So the phone calls in the middle of the night I take, regardless where they come from, because it's important, because I know what it was like to be told that I had GIST and to go home and get my life in order because I wasn't going to live more than a year. So my phone goes wherever I go. If it's in the shower, if it's in the kitchen and all that, or in the middle of the night. So with that said and done, I think we all know that the importance of what we have to do to make a difference and to help the researchers, since the government is not that quick to help with the orphan cancers. And of course, the doctors have to actually sit the right grant to send out, and they have to wait. And we don't have time to wait. So every one of you here that understands that it's a great thing that you are making the difference in only not in our lives, but in so many other people's lives. But it's also a good thing to remember that whatever you're doing, you could also try to reach out to others to be able to reach out back to us and support us in fundraising as much as possible.